So a big question that people always have after a Bleach series ends or a Bleach core ends is, did Bleach, the anime, for that core or that season do well? Whether it be through the eyes of the audience or in the eyes of the Japanese industry. And we're gonna get to that right now. So if you are interested to know if Bleach, the Thousand Year Blood War arc did do well this year, then stick around. Of course, always hit that like and subscribe because it does help out the channel a lot. So let's get into it. We have TV Tokyo's fiscal reports, and we kind of have to use this as somewhat of a baseline. No, I don't really like using this as a baseline because we don't really truly know what Disney's numbers are. We don't really get to see viewing figures, so to say. All I can say is that if memory recalls correctly, that one of the episodes for Core 2 did in fact make it on the top 10 viewing charts for TV Tokyo's TV ratings on Oricon. But I'm not going to use that because I don't have the reference point on me currently, so you'll just have to take my word for it. But as you can see on screen right now, Bleach did in fact hit top 3 out of the 5 for TV Tokyo's rankings, which at the bottom is Pocket Monsters or Pokemon, then Yu-Gi-Oh, then Bleach, and then Boruto, and then Naruto. And we're going to be explaining a little bit as to why it's at the third position and why not maybe higher, and why I don't really like using the fiscal reports too much when it comes to an indication of success. Now, as I said, I don't really like using this ranking process because I already did a 2-hour live stream explaining this, going right into detail into the in-depth report that TV Tokyo do give. But I also want to give this as a very simple or more of a simplistic answer to give you right off the bat. Now, one why I don't think this is fair is because at number 5, we have Pokemon. As we know, Pokemon is a behemoth of a company. So when it comes to TV Tokyo, they only take an actual very small percentage of what, you know, Pokemon actually brings in terms of revenue. Most of it goes to Game Freak, most of it goes to the Pokemon company. So when it comes to Pokemon on TV Tokyo, it is strictly through advertising and TV ratings at this point, hence why it's so low. Anyways, if it was all of TV Tokyo collectively that owned it, it would be massively higher. As we all know, it would probably dominate the majority of top fives going forward into the future and in the past. So again, not an actual representation of Pokemon's success through this fiscal report. Then we have Yu-Gi-Oh, which again, Yu-Gi-Oh is primarily going to its revenue to Konami rather than TV Tokyo again. So again, it is mainly the anime and its advertisements on, you know, TV Tokyo. So again, not a true representation of how much of a behemoth that Yu-Gi-Oh actually is. And of course, with the card game and whatnot, you know, most of that revenue is going to go to Konami, especially when it comes to worldwide distribution. Then we have Bleach, which we will go a little bit more in depth into, and of course Boruto and Naruto, and why they are primarily the top 3 in this instance. Now, considering that this video is talking about, did the Bleach anime do well in terms of an anime, specifically an anime, Bleach is actually technically number 1 within this chart, because that's what Bleach's fiscal report in this case is focused on. So let me read to you what the report actually says and why it's not number 1. The main sources of income are from the sales of programs to overseas audiences, rights to make games, content supply for internet-based pay-per-view distribution platforms, and advertising-supported video distribution platforms, as well as events. In the animation division, sales of the mainstay animation series, Bleach the Thousand Year Blood War arc, were strong worldwide, while the sales of Boruto SNS game increased in China, and the merchandising of Naruto in Europe remained strong. So, what can we take away from this? Well, as an anime, Bleach was the biggest hitter for TV Tokyo this year, which is interesting because there's no Chainsaw Man, nor is there Spy Family, and the reason for that is because obviously Chainsaw Man, all the revenue kind of went to MAPPA, as Chainsaw Man was like a pretty much 100% funded series, so it makes sense that most of the merchandising or even, you know, TV sales and advertising went straight to MAPPA. And on the flip side, Spy Family, I assume, also probably got most of its popularity through streaming platforms such as like Netflix, I would imagine. And the reason why I say this is because Bleach is still very much within, or the IP as well as Naruto is still very much within the old production committee method from like 20 years ago, right? Where TV Tokyo was a main investor within the series of the production committee, following up with Shueisha, Dentsu, and of course TV Tokyo. And Pierrot is also a part of that production committee too. But the main three are TV Tokyo, Pierrot, and Shueisha, so they split the money essentially in three ways. And the same would be with Naruto and Boruto as well. Most newer series are kind of funded more so by sponsorship, so the revenue is more so split more diversely than more specifically to a chunk of people. All that waffle being said, now the main reasons why Naruto and Boruto are number one and number two is the simple reason of the same thing that these reports say time and time again, to which again we did a 2-hour live stream, we broke it down, we saw every year the reasoning towards this, and none of it was ever in regards to animation. It was always in regards to games. America love Naruto, Europe love Naruto, and obviously China is really boosting Naruto and Boruto as well. And why is this? It's the simple fact that the Naruto franchise, including Boruto, has so many games, not one, not two, not three, even more than three games that can be continuously revenue shared throughout worldwide territories. It is simply being carried by the amount of games that the series has, which makes sense because the gaming industry worldwide is much more stronger than an anime industry is worldwide. This makes sense. We all know this. Bleach has Bleach Brave Souls, which domestically for Japan does extremely well in terms of, you know, as Bleach Brave Souls goes. However, did Bleach Brave Souls reach a worldwide market? Not particularly. It barely really touched America in that regard. It definitely barely touched Europe, and it does somewhat well in China, if memory serves correctly, though I don't really know specifically. But we have one game competing with how many Naruto games, how many IP sales that Naruto games get in general. And most of it has the Boruto IP attached to that, which we can see in the trademarks of the majority of Naruto and Boruto games, is it has Naruto and Boruto trademarks within there, and it is the same IP trademark. So in terms of the anime, and did it do well, don't be discouraged by the fact that it is number three, because realistically, we're fighting a series that basically is being carried by the amount of long-term longevity of games that it has and the amount of revenue that these games bring to the table. It is not a reflection on whether the Naruto or Boruto anime is doing successfully in comparison to Bleach, nor is it in comparison to whether the manga is doing better than Bleach at all. Bleach is doing extremely well, and in terms of animation, is TV Tokyo's number one hitter currently as far as these reports go. Again, we're fighting a series that has multiple games while we have essentially none. However, with that being said, shout outs to Bleach Soul Resonance. That should be coming out. It should be coming out, alright? And you guys are going to hear more information about that soon. And hopefully, you know, this adds to the revenue sources that Bleach is going to have in the future. And hopefully, you know, we might be able to see an increase in maybe that ranking position. But then again, I don't really think these reports are a fair evaluation, because when we see, especially on Twitter, when we see a ranking of 1 to 5, we just assume, or we don't, but a lot of people assume that, hey, this series is up here and this series is down here, and they just think that it's infinitely better. While in context, actually it's not. So, as an anime, did Bleach do well? It seems to be the case. Bleach did fantastically well. Though I have my gripes about Core 2, and I will do a video about that in general, it did successfully, and I'm glad that it did successfully. So, tell me your guys' thoughts in the comment section down below about what you think of these sales reports in general. With that being said, I'm going to catch you motherfuckers later. You guys, of course, have this fine David Hanson, and as always, people, peace out and stay educated. And don't let random Twitter people just spread lies. Peace out.